more than righteousness. That's why they don't teach it, because they don't live it. Any pastor that doesn't preach repentance, it's probably because he hasn't repented. Jesus says, "Be zealous therefore and repent. Behold, I stand at the door and knock. If any man hear my voice," you got to hear his voice. "If any man hear my voice and open the door, I will come to him and will sup with him, and he with me. To him who overcometh will I grant to sit with me in my throne, even as I also overcame and am set down with my Father in his throne." You can sit with him in his throne? Yes. I didn't feel like an overcomer that day. He's like, "Well, you have to wait till you die." Well, I've already been crucified with Christ. I'm long out. It's not me not living anymore. You know what? I was still dying. I was still dying to myself. Anyways, "Grant to sit with me in my throne, even as I also overcame, and am set down with my Father in his throne. He who has an ear, let him hear what the Spirit says to the churches." Whoever has an ear, they will hear. What are they going to hear? What the Spirit says. Are they going to hear what a pastor says? Are they going to hear what the flesh says? Or are they going to hear what the Spirit says to the churches? I tell you the truth, I did not feel like an overcomer when I sat on the throne. I felt so defeated. I felt like I missed something. I don't know what's wrong, God. I don't know how to fix this. Help. And I just prayed in tongues and I cried out to the living God. And he rebuked me in unconditional love. Is the billows of the Father. I've said it before in my other, just go watch it. The Third Heaven with God remix. And it changed me. By beholding him, even though I looked at him, I couldn't even see his face. It's just light, this white love. The light is love coming out of him. And it's not that he's giving you love, he's giving you himself. He is love. And he's just radiating who he is. I mean, he's the source of all life on the earth and everywhere else. The angels, cherubim, the source of life. And I could see him just almost like heaving, just in almost like an agony at this person would not receive the love of God. It just broke my heart. I saw my own wretchedness as he just like, God, just heaving, just to this person could just open their eyes and see the living God, how much he loves them unconditionally. God didn't even look at me. God didn't even look at me. He was rebuking me in unconditional love. He was looking at the people that I wouldn't look at in unconditional love. You can only give what you've received. In heaven, I received unconditional love, so I can freely give it. Doesn't matter what you do to me. Doesn't matter how much you hate me. Doesn't matter if you want to murder me. They did that to Jesus Christ and he still opened up his arms and said, "Father, forgive them. They don't know what they're doing. They don't know. They have no idea that this is even, I was crucified from the foundation of the world for the very ones who are hammering those nails into my hands, hammering those nails into my feet, and putting that crown of thorns in my head so that they can have the mind of Christ. They can have my touch. They can walk in my peace. Doing this for them." We don't know the living God as we should. Never cap off. At any level, there's always more. There's always more to get to know the living God. I'm gonna stop this video here. I think I'm gonna go lay on the couch again.